may be interested to hear about the real Tannhauser, around whose adventures Richard Wagner wove the story of his wonderful opera. Tannhauser was a German minnesinger, a poet of the 13th century, who lived for a time at the court of Frederick, Duke of Austria. After the death of the Duke, Tannhauser was received at the court of Otto II. He was of a restless disposition, however, and after wasting his fortune, spent much time in wandering about Germany. He also joined one of the Crusades to the Holy Land. Tannhauser's adventurous life caused him to be identified in the popular imagination with the knight Tannhauser, who, after wandering over the country, went to dwell in Venusberg. This legend of Tannhauser was once widely known in Germany. Even as late as 1830, it was the subject of a popular song. In the Venusberg, where the goddess of love holds her court, Tannhauser lives for some time. Then, overcome by remorse, he returns to the world and falls in love with Elizabeth. She, hoping to redeem him, sends him to Rome to pray forgiveness of the Pope. He is refused absolution, however, and goes out into the world heartbroken and alone. Elizabeth, meanwhile, pines away in hopeless waiting for her loved one's return. Finally, the Pope does pardon Tannhauser, but the pardon reaches him only after he has dropped lifeless at the bier of his devoted Elizabeth. The story teaches the lesson of salvation to man through the untiring devotion of woman. It is the old, old tale of the struggle of the human soul between good and evil and the sinner's final redemption through the help and love of a pure woman. When Richard Wagner first attempted the production of Tannhauser, he was confronted with many difficulties. The public did not understand his music and did not attempt to. Even the singers themselves were bewildered and thought the music too eccentric to sing. The opera survived, however, and now Act Three, with its wonderful melody, "O Thou Sublime Sweet Evening Star," holds the audience spellbound. The third act shows a valley with a shrine on one side. Wolfram, a man of noble nature, is vainly in love with Elizabeth. At this point in the opera, the latter is waiting for Tannhauser, who is supposed to be with a band of returning pilgrims. When the despairing maiden finds he is not among them, she kneels at the shrine, and, having offered up her prayer to the Virgin, she slowly ascends the height and disappears from view, leaving Wolfram gazing sadly after her. He seats himself at the foot of the hill, begins to play upon his harp, and then sings the noble ode to the evening star, which is considered one of the finest melodies in the whole realm of music. The gloomy despair of Wolfram's unrequited love occupies the first portion of the aria, soon changing to the exalted calm and almost religious tranquility of the melody itself. Arthur Middleton was born, raised, and educated in the state of Iowa. At an early age, his voice developed to such an extent that he was enabled to fill many important oratorio engagements in the Middle West. Early in 1914, he joined the Metropolitan Opera Company, premier organization of its kind in the United States, and since that time has become one of its leading battles.